How's it going, everybody? Today I'm going to do a 20 questions wine trivia video, and I'm also going to drink some of this Italian wine that I've got with it. I know usually I do the Northeast Ohio wine, but today I just happened to get this really awesome Italian wine, and it is so good. It is phenomenal. It is fantastic. It is probably one of the best tasting wines I've had today. Yep. For shizzle. Anyhow, so let's get on with this 20 questions wine trivia game. And the game begins. How much wine is in a typical bottle of wine?
All of it.
I'm going to say 750 milliliters for a fifth and 1.5 liters for a mag. And going down to the answers, we have 750 milliliters for fifths, a fifth of a gallon, and 1.5 liters for mag. Yep, I was right.
So by the gallon and by the box.
I've got another one later. We'll get to that question. What are the varieties in a typical Bordeaux red blend wine? So I'm aware of about five, maybe six. So I want to say Cabernet Sauvignon, Cabernet Franc, Merlot, Petit Verdot, and Malbec. And I've also heard some blends contain Carmenere. Some blends contain one or two more, but I think basically it's those five or six. That's what I'm gonna say.
Sorry, the correct answer was grapes.
Yep, there it is. Cab Sauv, Cab Franc, Merlot, Petit Verdot, and Malbec. For your basic Bordeaux blend. Alright, question number three. How many grapes does it take to make a bottle of wine? 42.
14 grapes.
I'm guessing they probably want weight. So we'll say between, let's see, for one bottle of wine, how many grapes? Like these little guys. How many of these? I want to say between like 2 and 4 pounds, probably.
8,726 grapes exactly.
The voice on the side says 8,726 grapes exactly. Let's see. We have 2.5 pounds of grapes are needed for one bottle of wine. All right, I said between 2 and 4. Yeah, and he was right with his 2,000 or whatever. I mean, that's, what, 2.5 pounds, yeah. Okay, so where does the vanilla flavor in wine come from? One of the side voices just said vanilla bean. I'm gonna say the oak barrels. There's French oak and American oak. And I want to say American oak makes more of the vanilla flavor, especially when it's new. You're generally supposed to use new barrels. And the answer is new oak barrels. Alright, question number five. What century was the corkscrew designed in? Well, wine has been around for a long time. A long time. So, I want to say back in the 1600s they were probably making wine. They were probably making wine before the 1600s. But the technology to create a corkscrew probably didn't come out until a little bit later. Like maybe the 1700s or the 1800s. hard to determine if it was the 1700s or the 1800s. I'm gonna say the 1700s. What do we get from the audience out there?
Couldn't tell ya.
Okay.
I'm gonna guess that last century, because design of corks were real big.
So, I said the 17th or the 18th century. It's gotta be somewhere in there. I know wine's been around much longer than that. Let's scroll down to see the answer. It is, for number 5, mid-1800s.
Kind of late for how long they've been making wine.
Alright, number 6. How many standard wine bottles equals one Nebuchadnezzar? I'm going to say that again. The Nebuchadnezzar. Like the Nebuchadnezzar? Let's see. Nebuchadnezzar. Nebuchadnezzar. Like the Matrix? Like the name of the craft they were flying around in the Matrix?
What?
I'm pretty sure that was... The Nebuchadnezzar.
Nice pop culture reference.
Yeah. So, how many standard wine bottles equal one Nebuchadnezzar?
I mean, that's a pretty big ship. I mean, it's been a while since I've seen the Matrix, but that's a lot of wine barrels.
I'm pretty sure the Nebuchadnezzar really has nothing to do with the spacecraft from the movie The Matrix. It's probably a measurement of wine, like a bigger bottle, I'm guessing, obviously. How many standard wine bottles equals one Nebuchadnezzar? So, audience responses goes with 2.5 and 50. I'm just gonna plop right in the middle of that and say 25. Let's see, scroll down to the answers and see what we get for number 6. 20 standard 750 milliliter bottles. Because a Nebuchadnezzar is a large wine bottle.
Well, you guys are both over, so does that mean I win?
You said 2.5.
Yeah, you guessed over, he guessed over.
You guessed under.
But according to Price is Right, it's
It's not who's closest?
No.
Because I was within 5.
You go over, it's a 5.
I guessed 25 when the answer was 20.
Yeah, I mean,
if you have 22 and the dealer had 20, the dealer still wins.
Blackjack rules, huh? Okay. Let's see, back to question number 7. What is fortified wine? Fortified wine has spirits added to it, vodka or brandy or any kind of high-spirited liquor.
No. Fortified wine is when you have wine in a fort. That's why it's fortified.
Yes, had brandy or another spirit added to the wine base.
So if you make a pillow for it or a blanket for it and you drink wine,
all these YouTube channels have these Fortnite challenges.
There you go.
So if you drink wine all night in a fort on YouTube, then you have a proper wine Fortnite video.
Or if you drink wine while playing Fortnite.
I personally don't know a whole lot about Fortnite. Did I just say that? Gas! Alright, so for the next question, question number 8. What happens when you press red grapes like a white?
Make a different sound.
Are we talking about like with our feet, or how are we pressing?
You could stomp on them with your feet. That's the old method. Some grape growers still practice these methods. But anyways, if you take red grapes and press those, typically you're supposed to ferment them on the skins first to create your red wine. White grapes, there's no reason for that. You don't want to ferment them on the skins. It doesn't taste as well, so you just press those. So the red grapes, if you take them and press them like a white without fermenting them on the skins, you actually get a rosé. Turns out like a pinkish colored wine. And it is called rosé. What was that? Question number...
Are you going to look up the answer to that one?
Yeah. That was question number 8. That's the correct answer. Question number 9. The wine with the fewest calories is dry. True or false? The wine with the fewest calories is dry. True or false?
I would say true.
You got dry wines versus sweet wines, and that's what you're comparing.
I suppose it depends on what kind of calories you're talking about. I mean, if I go back to chemistry class and physics class, a calorie is something entirely different.
What I learned from science was that calories are a measurement of the food or whatever it is set on fire and burning. Yeah, yeah. The temperature? Or how long? I think it's how long. How long it burns. Or something like that. I don't know. Let's light some wine on fire and see how long it burns for.
Sweet wine and dry wine.
Yeah.
Say which one has more.
So, let's see, the fewest calories being dry versus sweet, I would say probably true. That's probably fewer calories with a dry wine than with a sweet wine. Sweet wine has more to it to give it calories. And sure enough, true, sweet wines contain more sugar and more calories than white wine. Than dry wine, sorry. Okay, so question number 10. How do you get to Marco Vineyards? Alright. So, you can take a horse, or you could fly via eagle, but you could ice skate in the winter. And they don't do a whole lot of snow plow or salting on that road during the winter, so you probably could easily ice skate to his vineyard during the winter. Yeah, it's one of the sad things about it. They don't do a whole lot of road maintenance. But anyways, it is a truly remarkable vineyard. Arnie Esterer started this vineyard 50 years ago, over 50 years ago. He's the grandfather of Ohio vinifera, and we've got this lovely book that they wrote about the man from Clifford Annis. He created this Magic in a Bottle book talking all about Arnie Esterer and Marco Vineyards and his whole journey. That is one awesome book to read. So to get to Marco Vineyards from I-90, you get off of I-90 on State Route 193 and drive north to State Route 84. There's an intersection there, but State Route 84 ends at that intersection and it turns into South Ridge Road. And it's a dirt road. Well, no, it starts off at that point at the intersection, it's still paved. But further on down you go, it turns into a dirt road. You'll go maybe 3 or 4 miles down the road. And finally, you can keep on going straight. But you can also, you'll get to a part where the road turns right and goes underneath I-90. And then at that same spot, you can go left onto the driveway of Marco Vineyards. And he has a big sign that says Marco Vineyards. But it, after that sign in the driveway, it's all woods and you can't actually see the winery. So it's very hidden. But that does not mean that you shouldn't go there. You should absolutely go there. Try his Riesling. Try his Chardonnay. And my God, I absolutely love his Cabernet Sauvignon. I got my first autographed bottle right here. From Arnie Esterer. And I will never ever open that bottle. It's the first bottle of my autographed bottle collection. So I'll go to winemaker and get more autographed bottles from them to create my collection. I just went off on a rant, didn't I? So I did the first 10 questions of my 20 question wine trivia challenge. I'm gonna go ahead and end this video for now because this is getting big and I won't want these to be hour-long videos. So I will continue the second half of my 20 question trivia game in another video. Until then, I'm the red-bearded wine snob. Enjoy the wines and enjoy the vines. I'll see you next time. Cheers.